Hello friends, this is Durga again from Technology Mentor slash IT Varsity, and as part of MapReduce application development using Hadoop APIs, we have seen so many things so far, starting from default mapper reducer and then developing a simple record count MapReduce application where we have written custom mapper with and used existing reducer called longsum reducer. And also as part of that process, we understood what input and output formats are, what key and value types are, etc. And eventually we understood intrinsic details about how mappers are determined, how developers need to come up with a number of reducers. And then we have written a complex MapReduce application to get average stock volume per month of our 5 years stock data. And as part of that, we have developed custom key and value types. We have used combined text input format to address too many small files. And so many things we have learned as part of the process, especially the complete MapReduce application development lifecycle, starting from understanding the requirements, developing the plain old Java object classes to build the objects while processing the data. And then what logic should be implemented in mapper, what logic should be implemented in reducer, and many other things. And now we are getting into another very important topic when dealing with the data, which is called as filtering. And as MapReduce application development is done in Java, you can do filtering wherever you want. You can do it in the driver class. As part of the run method, you can do it in mapper, you can do it in reducer, you can have additional classes, and you can take care of it. But you need to understand the specialization of each of these classes. Driver is actually to configure certain things for your MapReduce application. Mapper is primarily to do transformations, filtering, etc. And reducer is for aggregations, joins, etc. And then the shuffle and sort framework to sort the data, which I have explained earlier as well. When it comes to filtering, they have to be developers. When I say they, developers have to be aware of that file input format can be leveraged to apply filters while setting the job configurations itself. So as part of the job configuration, we know that we can actually set the input paths like this. And we can actually apply some filters here itself. So for example, if you go back to the Hadoop APIs, the file input format have some methods related to filters in them. You can use them as well. And also we I have covered file system API earlier, which includes file system, file util, file status, path, path filter, etc. And you can leverage those also to actually apply filters on top of your, the data set. So let's go ahead and understand a little bit of details about our requirement. So the problem statement is get average stock volume per month for year 2012 and 2013 for few handful of stocks. So if you divide this statement into two, the first part, which is not highlighted, is to get average stock volume per month, which is same as our previous MapReduce application. So we have the code ready for that. Now we have to add additional functionality to filter 2012-2013 and also to run only for a handful of stocks. So again, this new additional requirement have two components to it. One is to filter by year and then filter by stock. So the fundamental design consideration for any application is to filter as much as possible, as early as possible in the development lifecycle. That applies even for MapReduce. And your filtering requirements drives the naming conventions of the directories that are used while loading data. So in this case, when we are dealing with New York Stock Exchange data, and when the loading process loads the data, it has to follow certain standards or conventions where we can leverage while filtering data as part of our downstream modules. So to develop filtering effectively, one need to understand file system APIs and also configuration APIs so that we can leverage these things to filter effectively. Okay. So here we have to filter by year and then by stocks. And if you see the naming convention of our directories, they are of this format, nyse underscore and then yyyy, which stands for year. So if you go back here, and I'm in the right, so there is another subdirectory called raw data, and here I have directories, and it has the files which have actual data we are interested in. And in this, if you see, the directory names are prefixed with nyse underscore. So even if you have other directories in the same location, you can apply our file system APIs, which I have explained as part of earlier videos, and apply and only try to get the directories which have nyse underscore prefix in them. And on top of that, we can also, in this problem statement, we want it to be done only for 2012 and 2013. So now if you see, the directory names have the years. So if we discard the other four directories, then 12 and 13, then the amount of data that needs to be read by mapper itself will go down. So you are actually filtering at directory level itself, even before you are invoking the mapper. And then there is a second part to it, where we want to do it with handful of stocks. And for that, we will use something called configuration API to do filtering effectively, and we will see that later. For now, let's see how we can filter out the directories using the knowledge which we have gained as part of earlier two videos to access only the directories we are interested in. Let's go ahead and do that. So if you go back to the videos, I have developed this code, and only changes I have instead of hard coding, I have added additional parameter to this program. Earlier it used to be something like this: nyse underscore 1 and 1, 2, 3 when I actually try to test it. Okay, but instead of that, I just made it an argument. So I replaced this with args of 1, and we will use similar approach, because when I pass that nyse underscore and the pattern, it did not like it, errored out. That's why I have hard coded when I demonstrated earlier. So we'll use this one. So because we have to have two parameters to build our filter condition to filter the directories we are interested in, our program so far, which is taking two parameters, has to take three parameters. Okay, let's start working on that. So first, I want to build a configuration object, because I have to use in multiple places, which you will understand in a moment, and I will assign getconf to that. So now we will have a configuration object. It's getconf, and here, instead of using getconf, I am using conf itself. Okay, and then if you go to get files, here we are actually using these two lines to set the these three lines to set the paths, so we can actually use most of this code. So I'm copying here this one to this, and then I will make necessary modifications. So let me first comment these out and add one line after the other. Sorry. Okay, so here first I need to create a file system object so that I can access the file names. So for that, I can use file system.get and pass the string URI. So in this case, URI is nothing but args of 0, sorry, arg 0 of 0, because our argument variable name is arg 0. So now we have the file system object, and then we have to build the path object, and it requires two parameters. So for that, here it should be arg 0 and it should be arg 0 1. So the first two parameters in combination will drive the pattern of our input path. So here, when it comes to output path, it should be 2. So the third parameter will be the output path for our program. So I'm making that change. If you do not change this, then it will error out because you are trying to pass that NYSC underscore blah 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 as both suffix to your input and also as output. So you have to fix this. And then you can uncomment this line. There is nothing here. And then you have to do the glob status on the argument 0 and argument 1. So this is correct. There is no need to change this. And then we need to get the paths. So we are building a path array. So you can reuse it. And here, instead of printing out, what I will do is, or I will actually, on top of printing out those paths, I will also invoke set input paths. So set input paths, you can add multiple input paths one after the other. All those paths will be processed by the mapper. Here, instead of using new path, blah, 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 we have to pass each path. So when this program runs, it will get three paths. If you pass based upon, it will get the number of paths based upon the this pattern. So for example, if you pass it as one as NYSC underscore 2001 2 minus 3. So this will be evaluated into two paths. So this will have two paths with the full name, which we'll see when we actually print. And both those paths will be added as input path for our mapper. So that's it. So now we can actually filter out the directories which are not required, which serves the first part of our problem statement. And then right click on this, run as, run configurations. And I want to create a new application, which is average stock volume per month driver. And arguments, I have to pass users, USD Gariraj, and then research, big data, raw data, which is my first parameter. And second parameter is NYSC 201, and I want for 2012 and 2013. And the third parameter will be, here it is data NYSC. Third parameter will be this one, with which says output average volume per average stock volume per year filtering. So I am just to have a different name while running this program. Then click on apply, click on run, and the program will run in a moment. So it is actually processing 2012 and 2013. And let's see if it is done. It is pretty fast. Yeah. So it has created this directory. And now you can, oh, but it didn't process anything. So let me troubleshoot it. Okay. I know the problem. The problem is this line. It, as we are setting the path here, we have to comment out this one. Okay, and save it. So instead of commenting out, I am deleting this. You should not have this line because it is probably overriding this one, or it might be throwing some error which we have not seen, because when we run through Eclipse, because of the logging level, it will not show everything. So run as, run configurations, and click on run. So it says output path, output directory already exists. So we have to do rm minus rs. It is actually per month. So let me fix the directory name. run as run configurations arguments. It should be per year, stock volume per month, not per year. Okay, apply and run. Now it is running. So it is taking time this time. So probably it might work this time. So it completed. Now let's review. LSLTR, it has created the directory, and let us see the contents of this. And you can see the data in this. So we can go to the directory and cat the file. And you can see data related to 2013 here. Let me do this. So cat part star awk I'm validating whether it is working as expected or not. Print. Okay, it didn't work. It only worked for 2013. So what's happening is in the loop, it is only picking up the last one. So set input path is not the right one. Here we should use add input path. So if you go to file input format, there is a method for add input path. So you can use that one. Okay, and then you can run it after deleting the directory. And I ran it already, and now after going to the directory and validating the same command. So what I'm trying to do is I'm catting all the files with part prefix. That's what part star means. And then awk is a shell command, a shell script. And I'm trying to pass the tab as delimiter because our data is delimited by tab. If you look at the toString function of our path, so for both key and value types as well as the for key and value types, you can see that the key is delimited by tab, and in our case it's a composite key. The first one is the year and the second one is stock, so that's why it worked. I have delimited using tab, and then I am printing the first field after delimiting it. And then once the output comes, there are many records with those values. I want to sort them and do the unique on them so that I can see all the unique keys. And you can see that the data is all having only 2012 and 2013, not everything. Okay, so now you can actually run this in the cluster also if you want to confirm, but we will see that later. We will run on the cluster once we complete the entire flow. We have only finished one part of our problem statement, which is by filtering by year and doing average, and we have done average volume per month for those 2 years. But the second portion is we should be able to do it with handful of stocks, and I will take care as part of the next video. And once everything is done, we will run the program in the cluster and see the difference of applying these different types of filters. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content so far in my channel. If you like the content of a particular video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide any feedback or ask any technical questions, please use the comment section of video. And then if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will see a lot of content over time. Thank you. Bye.